So hey guys, today we will learn about git alias command. So first of all, let's go to the git alias official documentation. So you can see this is the official documentation of git alias, and let's do it practically. So let's go to our folder, git tutorial folder, and let's go into the git bash and let's write over here git status. It's in caps lock, git status. Yeah, so there is nothing to commit, our working tree is totally clean. And suppose you like, yeah, this comment is short, you can write it every time, okay? But suppose this comment, so this is so long and you don't want to type this long comment every time, so you just want to put it short. So for example, if I short this git status command into git st, it will not run. Obviously, it will show that st is not a git command, see git help, or it will suggest you some similar kind of comment like status, stage, stash, etc. Okay, so like when you are coding for a long time and you don't want to put a longer code and you just want to put some shorter code, in that case git alias help you a lot. So to use git alias, you just need to write git config hyphen hyphen global alias, then a full stop, and after that the short form which you want to use. For example, I want to use st instead of status. So it basically means that the status git status command is there, okay, it will not change, but if you use git st, it will automatically redirect the git status command and it will show what it should be shown when you type git status command. So now if I press enter and now if I write git st, you will see nothing to commit, working tree is clean. And if I write git status, you can see both are showing the similar things, right? Now let's do some changes over here. For example, in example 1.txt, I added git alias tutorial and save it. And now if I go and write over here git st, you can see the example 1.txt is modified. Now if I want to add into this staging area git add dot, and it will be added into the staging area. And now if I write git st or git status, whatever, it will show the example 1.txt is in the staging area. That's why it is showing that into the green font. Now suppose you want to unstage the example 1.txt, so to do that you have to write this comment, git restore hyphen hyphen staged. So let's write that thing, git restore hyphen hyphen staged, and then the file name, that is the example 1.txt. okay, but you can clearly see this comment is so long. So what if you just write the git unstage, what if you just write git unstage and then the file name? Obviously it will not run because git unstage, it is not an official comment. So like let's do that with the previous comment, git restore, and then after that git restore hyphen hyphen staged, then the file name, then click enter. And now if I write git status, you can see this is like untracked, or you can say unstaged. Now let's add it again into the staging area. Now if I write git status, you can see now it is staged. And now let's change the git now change this comment, the git unstage. Okay, so we have to write git config hyphen hyphen global, then global alias dot unstaged, and after that, that means unstaged is a short form which we will use, and the full form is restore hyphen hyphen staged. Okay, so when there is more than one word, for example, where is that? Yeah, so for example, here we put the status without any inverted commas. That is because a status is only one word. But here the here the restore hyphen hyphen stage is more than one word. So that's why if you put the total words without any inverted commas, it will not run. Whenever there is a more than one words, you have to write that into this inverted commas. And like this, okay, inverted comma, then the total words, and after that the inverted comma should be closed. Now let's press enter. And you already saw that if I write this comment git restore hyphen hyphen staged example 1.txt, it will unstage the example 1.txt and it became in the red font, right? So now let's, now if I write git status again here, you can see it is now staged. That's why it is showing in the green font. Now let's move that into unstaged. Okay, so we will just write git unstaged, then the file name. Okay, because we put unstaged as a short form of the total command, that is restore hyphen hyphen staged. Now if I write git st, or you can say git status, now you can see the example 1.txt is unstaged. So in this way, you can put longer comments into a shorter form.